Forbidden Planet 1956, if you do not know, this is where Robbie the Robot comes from. Robbie the Robot, of course, was copied in several other movies and TV series over the years. Including, I do believe, Lost in Space, the original Lost in Space. It was a duplicate of Robbie the Robot. So, these people from the Federation of Planets or planetary something go to see if there's survivors of a mission to a far-off world. They find only two survivors, one survivor and an offspring of the survivor. Basically, Dr. Morbius being the person who is the only survivor of the original crew. There is a vast alien machine under the ground that repairs itself and does things. There's no instrumentality, no dials, no gauges, no interfaces whatsoever. It's just there, basically, right? But the thing is it can be operated by the mind if your mind is strong enough. Dr. Morbius, you find out, has a strong enough mind, sort of. Not consciously, but subconsciously. This leads to a very dangerous dilemma, of course. Yeppers, classic sci-fi movie. I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. Fantastic Planet 1973. So these human-like creatures are very small, like rodents small, and they're treated like rodents, a pest to by the rather large alien creatures, except one who is kept as a pet by one of the aliens. It learns to use this learning device, which is rather giant to its size, that the aliens put on their head to learn things. And it teaches them all kinds of things like science and all that, right? So he brings it back to his people. He absconds with it, basically, and brings it back to his people and teaches them with it. And they evolve into learned creatures, basically. And this leads to conflict between them and some sort of a space race type thing where they build a spaceship and whatnot. There is an ultimate conflict near the end of the movie, of course. This is one of my favorite movies of all time. It's in my top 20 list, to say the least. 10 out of 10. It's animated, by the way. 12 to the Moon, 1960. So, an international team of scientists go off to the moon and encounter a alien species, faceless alien species. Anyways, the aliens decide that we're too primitive to be allowed to live and we're dangerous to them. And they decide they're going to wipe out humanity. So, of course, conflict ensues. 12 people against the entire race. But anyways, yeah, it's hokey. It's a B movie, but it's a time waster. 5 out of 10. The Red Monks, 1988. This is a remake of a 1974 movie that I have not seen, and I would hope it's better. Anyways, this woman marries a guy and she moves in with him, of course, to a very old mansion. And well, she starts really not liking him and the other people that dwell within the mansion. She finds out that there's a cult in the dungeon of the manor called the Red Monks, and he has, of course, ties to this bloodthirsty cult. This is a really poor movie. It's not worthwhile if you ask me. I'm going to give it a 3 out of 10. The Enemy Below, 1957. This is a really good movie. 8 out of 10. Anyways, so there's this destroyer American destroyer in World War II that is having a bit of a duel with a German U-boat. Both of the captains are extremely experienced and extremely good tacticians. So it is an epic struggle between the two of them, of course. Well, we all know what happens because it's an American movie, right? Anyways, I mean, that's obvious from the beginning who's going to win, right? Anyways, 8 out of 10, I'm going to say for this one. I do believe that the movie Das Boot was, where they're in a U-boat and being bombarded by, with depth charges and all this stuff. Which is a German movie. I do believe that was derived from this movie, but I'm not certain. Anyways, 8 out of 10.